basically.
But I think that just speaks volumes about why Dota is in such a great spot right now.
The meta is self-belief and confidence. That's the meta.
The power of the heart. It's the meta.
Yeah, we've seen the same with the Lions. Their meta was the meta.
Wow. Very deep from Black. Thank you for that.
your meta is anti-mage invoker. Get the heck out of here.
Yeah.
You can win any game with the AM first pick. I'm just saying.
Yeah, in your dreams.
We'll have to see if they heed your advice or not. For now, their first picks will stay a bit more traditional, if you will. Oracle right into a Faceless Void there for Wings, while DC, for now, snag up Mirana and then look for the secondary grab. We'll anticipate possibly a Naga. I was going to say maybe Shadow Demon, but no.
Naga Siren counter. I mean, counters the Void. They've done it before.
Oh, yeah.
I expected a Shadow Demon too, to be honest, because it's just so good with the Mirana, but instead, they just want to go for the Naga Siren to completely counter the Void. And if you get a net on the mid laner, you can still arrow him pretty easily.
Both teams have their significant way of dealing with the Void. We saw from Wings last game, they picked the Pudge. This time, DC, obviously in a few games we saw, they like to go for the Naga against the Chronosphere to deal with it. Be it a support, be it a core.
And they get opposite reactions from their spectators. Pudge, hype, Naga.
I mean, to be fair, though, it's such a solid opening for Wings as well, because you have the Oracle already against the Mirana. That hero can pretty much protect two different people on this team from the burst of the Mirana once the Aghanim's is out. You know, you fade Ti6 one, and then you just pop ulti on the other.
The game yesterday, you just reminded me of
that's why I'm saying it's, like, so good.
Yeah, it's a hard counter. Like, literally a hard counter. Like, the only thing you do with Mirana is you blink next to people in your Starfall, and then he's like,
he's like, what?
Fate's Edict.
Fate's Edict.
I know you don't know the name of that spell.
Yeah, he just said it. Of course I know.
Fair enough.
Dude, to be fair, it took me like a year to learn what those things were called. I don't know why it was so hard for me to remember them, but
Purifying Flames, dude.
Yeah, that's his E.
Do you know his Q? Go.
Fortunes and...
I didn't ask you. I know you know. I was testing the cores, but it's all right.
You're a core player?
I am.
Yeah, so for Wings in the second ban phase, they choose to take out the Tide. Tide, a very good hero to deal with Chronosphere if you don't catch him in. It's very difficult for your teammates to run in. It's like, it works both ways. You want to Chrono the Tide, but if you don't get the Tide will be able to blink behind the bubble and just ravage your teammates.
And on top of that, it's like super good with Naga Siren. It's like Ti3, Ti2 meta, Naga Sleep into Ravage. It's still very, very strong, and people just don't want to deal with it.
Right, don't you think like Disruptor is probably better in that sense, where the setup is much easier than the Tide Ravage?
No, Disruptor is like way easier, and like the cooldown is way shorter as well.
Yeah.
But it also could be scared that they don't have a mech carrier as well, whereas Disruptor doesn't really fit into that slot.
Yeah, and that's a really good point about like Tide. Not many offlaners right now that offers that, being the mech carrier in the current meta. Only Tide and Darkseer does that.
Yeah.
Darkseer is actually a possibility for Wings too, right? I mean, now that we bring it up, because they have the Oracle themselves.
Yeah, super good with the Void as well. You can Chrono. I mean, you can like vacuum people into the Chrono. You Iron Shell the Void, make him like super strong early on.
Yeah, but the issue is like, it's not one of Moo's comfortable heroes. He plays best on Timber or Batrider.
No, no, we said for Wings, right?
Oh, yeah, for Wings, not for DC.
Okay.
The DC definitely wants their Batrider, their Timber Saw, his best heroes for sure. Like by far as well.
They'd also gotten rid of the Huskar, of course, on the side of DC. Yeah. An Oracle comes out, you got to make sure all bases are covered in the second phase. The second phase, is really where you hit the other team with those respect bans, and then obviously any sort of cheese bans if they're necessary.
So basically, like we mentioned, Wings took out the two mech carriers for the offlane for DC in case push comes in.
Student Walker.
They have good setup for the Sunstrike, so it's a very solid pick overall.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a bit surprised that DC banned Timber and Wings banned Darkseer. Like, I mean, we said Darkseer might be good for them and Timber is good for the other team.
No, Timber is like still good for... If you're going to run a Naga core, you don't want to deal with Timber. You'd rather deal with Invoker.
They always want to keep their options open. They always want to, like, with the last pick, they want to determine whether Naga is carry or support.
Yeah, but at the same time, going back to the Darkseer ban, I felt like if DC's lineup have Darkseer and Naga and you're running a Naga core, the lanes are always going to be pushed. I mean, I get your point where the Oracle's going to like crush the Darkseid in the lane, but you just Iron Talon in jungle at the start if you can't go to the lane. And when it comes to mid-game, it's going to be so annoying with the Iron Shell spam plus the Naga.
That's a very good point.
I mean, that's all putting a lot on the fact that it's going to be a Naga core, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
but they ban Timbers. It's like it's like a good sign that Naga might be a core.
I mean, they also ban Huskar. Of course, Huskar is like a really good ban against like Oracle in general, but that can also lead to like a Naga core because the game can't be like... you won't lose the game in like 20 minutes to a Huska.
Yeah, that's also very true about the Huska. Like Naga, you want to prolong the game, and Huska is the kind of those calls where you just run at the enemy when you have one or two like medium items, like Amulet plus one item, and you try to end the game at that point when Naga's not ready to deal with you.
Yeah. All right, like, that being said, DC, they've changed it up. They can change it up again.
I mean, there's still Shadow Demon for them. Shadow Demon seems really good for the Mirana setup. Naga, make more illusions.
And on cue, Shadow Demon comes out for DC.
Super good.
Very stable pick.
Yeah, yeah. For Wings right now, they might have to consider getting heroes that can deal with the illusions, because it's kind of obvious that DC are going to go for this core Naga with the Shadow Demon here.
But like, what? There's not that many heroes that can really do it. There's like a Lion, but there's way too many illusions for Lion to deal with it. Then we have like maybe like a Legion Commander offlane, but you don't really want to have that either.
Like a support Zeus or something. I only suggest because it's Wings. Who knows,
if it
right?
was Wings, maybe, yeah.
Dude, I like it. I like support Zeus.
I if they didn't have Invoker, I would look back to something like Magnus, just because of what we saw.
Yeah, maybe go for Cleave. Like I'm thinking. Yeah, I mean, there's still Sand King. I was like thinking something is still there in the pool that we are missing that deals with illusions.
They usually run Sand King offlane, right?
No, there was one game that I saw Isis, maybe two games that he played the Sand King like support on a position for.
Yeah, would be pretty good too here. Like they can go greedy if they want to, but usually DC with that draft they go like aggressive Trillian, and they like want to make it really hard for the enemy team scary to like farm up. And Void is a pretty like he's not a bad safe laner, but he doesn't offer like any damage.
Yeah, he doesn't pressure the offlane as much as like someone else like Luna.
Yeah. So like I do expect the Naga Siren to be most likely like in an aggressive tri-lane. Shadow Demon plus
one. How about
one.
Mid? You don't think there's a chance that they might do him mid?
No, it's very possible too, if you wanna like avoid pressure.
Yeah, but have they ever actually, because I know Wii doesn't play the hero, have they ever switched lanes where Wii joins the tri-lane and
no.
resolution is mid?
No, not so far.
I have not done that.
So probably based on that reason alone, that might not happen here.
Yeah. You think this is gonna go something like Kunkka again? One of their really favorite heroes? Kunkka, Shadow Demon,
I mean, it's
Naga
very
Siren.
Good here. It's good for catching out Sand King, especially the boat buff is great.
So you think that they would run like an aggro tri-lane with Naga with Kunkka plus Shadow Demon?
I mean, they did that in the past just to pressure the enemy offlane, and usually it works out really nicely, and then it just get like a huge lead.
No, dude.
We have not seen that baby boy for a long time.
Not in a long time.
They did it in the group game against OG. The game that they had Doom, they had a support Morphling, it was all against the anti-mage.
I mean, it's incredible against the Invoker and Void.
But that's the offlaner, right? Not position 4 support.
Yeah, offlaner.
Yeah.
Okay, Doom offlaner.
The nice thing about this hero is that you pretty much just go in, you get your spell off, and the damage is pretty much done. You know, one person's just out of the fight. And plus, he can go, he's very versatile, can go anywhere.
But you don't want to have him against Sand King, right? Like if it's actually Sand King offlane, you get completely destroyed.
Just know, you have to let Sand King deal with the tri-lane and not get a 1v1 matchup in this situation.
Yeah.
You definitely do not want that to happen for you.
That's why I think DC will just like try to avoid going aggressive tri-lane, no matter what they pick.
Yeah, but if they go, say, defensive lanes, do you think it's better to have Mirana as a support, or you just go for something else that, and just let Mirana go for the mid lane and be a core position?
No, I think whether it's better or not is not even important for DC, because Wii is just like so confident and comfortable in Mirana right now. He just makes plays happen like every game. Like we spoke about it before, positions are like good and fine and all, but...
I guess with that in mind, so Dazzle would probably be their best pick, right? Like Shadow Demon, Dazzle, and Naga, your lanes are super strong. Yeah.
Dazzle is amazing with both their heroes and against the enemy heroes as well.
Yeah, when they are trying to focus you in the bubble or the Sand King Barrow Strike, you just have the Grave to bail your teammate out.
But that being said, might still be a support Naga. It's very unlikely, but you know, DC, you never know until the last pick.
Yeah, I guess so.
And support Naga does have its... So it is a support Naga again.
All right.
So aggressive
trial. Aggro trial. Like, I don't like this for the single reason that if it's offlane Sand King, Doom is going to have a very, very hard time.
Yeah, but he's always good at recovery, right? Like, you have Devour, you can Iron Talon, and plus you're pretty much,
do,
I think...
Do you think it's worth it, though, for that?
Yeah, and because Sand King a free lane, though.
He can still be... He can be the mech carrier for the team as well. That's another thing.
Yeah, but do you want to give, like, the only real playmaker of Wings, like a good lane? Like, if that SK gets, like, a super fast blink, he can turn those fights around.
I mean, it's going to be a trade-off for sure, but I think for DC, they can still make it work.
Yeah, maybe they go defensive lane as well, so I'm not sure. So there's going to be a Slaughter support Sand King?
Offlane Slaughter, then.
I mean, in that 1v1, I think Doom's fine.
Now I like it way better.
Yeah.
Like, if they go aggro now, I actually think they're favored.
Yeah, I'm going with DC.
Yeah, I'm going with DC too.
Same.
We'll see if DC are going to be able to move ahead 2-0 in this best of five, or if Wings are going to be able to match things up 1-1. Let's send it over to the sidelines right now where we got our casters. It's going to be Toby 1 and Merlini.
And Team Mage.
DC versus Wings. First, these guys break the meta, then they make the meta, then they break it again just to give us a new thing, a new spectacle here on the main stage. The Doombringer pickup, now out for Digital Chaos. Ben, thoughts?
That's Mu's signature hero. That's when when I first saw Mu. I was like, wow, this guy's really good on a hero that wasn't super popular at the time. I think it's one of his best heroes. Similarly, on the side of Wings, we have the Invoker for Blink, which is what they won ESL Manila with.
Well, can't wait to see it. It's time to get into the game as game number two of this TI6 Grand Final is underway. Digital Chaos one game up over the Chinese Wings as we will be bringing in an Iron Talon Sand King for the off lane and an Iron Talon Slaughter. They're doubling the talons on these two boys.
It's going to be tough for them to stay in lane. Yeah, double Iron Talon.
Yeah, they're actually
right off the bat.
They're actually doing this.
And DC have already placed them as a reward on the high ground to make sure there aren't any Iron Talon shenanigans.
You wonder, like, do they come over and contest this as well? You can send an SD over. For now, like, you'd also be concerned about the SD rotations. What happens when he moves into mid lane? Setting Weehar up for some really good arrow combinations is an old classic combo. The SD Mirana together, you've even got the Ensnare from Misery, so multiple ways to enable resolution as well, like with static link combos, other ways. It's like DC just have everything as far as combos go, that Wings have a superior team fight.
Mm-hmm. I think Invoker's also one of the few heroes in mid that can actually stand up to the SD. Mirana, you want a hero with summons so that you can block the arrow without any of your supports having to rotate over there, but more so concerned about their Iron Talon.
Yeah, where do these guys go with that? Like, do you actually send one of them into the Radiant Jungle? Like, is that the way you start this off? Like, you're running double Iron Talon, so you've obviously...
You mean Dire Jungle?
you could. haven't seen a Radiant support invade the Dire Jungle for farming in, well, since Ricky's, like, Enigma started to try and dodge Ricky's.
Yeah, I think only Enigma can do that.
Yeah.
Maybe Doom too, actually.
Hey, but you could always pick an Enigma. I don't think anyone here would be sad about that.
So Mu will start off in the off lane. They're just safe lane. Try lane.
Yeah, so nothing unusual from them and the dual off lane from Wings, so...
But, you know, they're starting off Wings, they see that three heroes are up there, they expected the aggro.
Look at the quick rotations too, Mu walks all the way over, gets hit by the crush, Ice is Burn Strike, Shadow's on his way in, while the Static Link up on the top lane, they're battling there, and Innocence makes a break for the tree line. It's Mu who's trying to escape on the bottom. He actually devoured a centaur, got a three-man stomp, and trying to reach back to his own T1 tower. It won't happen, however.
How is Innocent still alive on this top lane?
I do not know. He's had so much damage, stolen misery. He hasn't even leveled an ability. Now he'll level up the ensnare, but what help is there? It's only that one range creep, and he actually... He stops him from attacking by putting the Fate's Edict on him.
Oh, they actually did not have enough damage and no vision inside those trees to finish off a solo Oracle after the Fate's Void have.
And I wish we could see that Mu player again on the bottom lane. That was superb from him. For now, though, the top lane, a little bit more difficult. Misery has leveled up in Snare early on, so we can't harass out with Riptide.
They just don't have enough damage to follow up. They need a lot of right clicks after the Static Link drains enough damage, but... No Uve, no way to really slow them down.
So make the best of what you got. That's what the Sand King can do. Mr. Iron Talon, go wherever the hell he wants. He does have a level 1 Burrow Strike, so it's also not great for him, but he has hit level 2, so the options are there. Faith deciding to go a little bit deeper into the Dire Jungle. So, hey, you said it. Like, is this that time when you send a Radiant Hero into the Dire Jungle and said Faith's actually going to loop all the way around? It's like he's here to pull the camp, the creep wave down to get some experience that way. But he won't find it. He doesn't have an Observer Ward either, so there's no way to establish vision inside the DC jungle to safely farm.
Yeah, he had to play especially carefully. He had to use two stomps on the bottom lane, or two crushes on the bottom lane, and a TP.
Mu might be... Okay, he's fine. He's got a Fortune Zen to slow him down. It's a level 2 time lock up for Shadow. But he would need some serious RNG to get through that Doombringer.
And a Doom is also an excellent pick versus the...
They're going top lane. Ice-Ice locked up to start with. It's the Ensnare. They're still stealing a lot of damage. Now also Ice-Ice, the Sentry Wards, both of them being dropped at the same time. Disruption is up here, but the three-man crush from Faith Beyond. Ice-Ice, one more attack. There it is. The Shadow Demon Poison will reach it. Ensnare into the slot out too. They can make this a 2-4, and they do. Digital Chaos, they couldn't find the time to inflict the damage before, but this time they found it.
Maybe a little bit of nerfs getting to Wings. They missed the Burrow Strike on that Nagasar and would have definitely helped them out a little bit there. And the Ensnare will take down too. And Wings, they are not one to really give up on the offlane, and I'm a little surprised by that because they do have Iron Talons, but Iron Talons aren't terribly useful if you're sitting in the lane. You'd prefer to have Stouts, Sows, Mangoes, Fairy Fires, Sticks, pretty much anything else aside from that. I guess the armor helps them a decent bit. However,
Zuxa scattered out, moving over. He starts with a poison, still got disruption available. Weeha, hard to hit that arrow, so he leaps over to try and hit the arrow. Maybe just a starfall. Barrister from Ice-Ice, dropping that SD low with a cold snap. It's Weeha who finds the first kill. The Sand King will get revenge, however, into the SD. And we'll have to back away as Slaughter rotates over. The crush to Wee, but Ice-Ice has no interest in being involved in this.
Still suffering on the mana front. They're not really getting too much value out of the Iron Talons that are under way too much stress from all these lanes under heavy fire from DC.
I'll take your tribute.
Easy bottle refresh for Wee, so he can go back up to full health, full mana. He does miss the bottom rune, however. Innocence made his way over for that.
Wonder what Build Shadow is going to go for. We see him get Lincoln's first a lot on the safe lane Void, and I think it's definitely warranted here versus the Doom.
At the same time, a lot of the faces points we've been seeing on the main stage have just picked up Vlad's early on as well. Mm-hmm. Probably depends on when Wings feels like they can fight. We still need to create some more space for this Slaughter. Like, yay, he's got Boots and Iron Talon, but the Dream is getting that early Blink Dagger. Right now, DC don't want to give him any level of space as they force into the Tier 1 tower, Ice-Ice. It's only a level 1 Barrow Strike. With the Crush, they do get the distance. It's also only a level 1 static link, so Resolution not stealing that much damage. He's put more points into the AoE of that plasma field.
But now DC, they don't have any creeps to take, so they're just gonna sit here. They have a very deep observer ward too, and Wings to look like they do not want to let this tower fall. Usually this tower is not that important, but this game a little bit more important because of the Iron Talon. They can't both utilize that south jungle. They need this large camp.
They're trying to go for a revenge on mid. That SK is wrapped all the way around the back lines. He has the observer ward on his hillside. It's going to time out in 8 seconds time, but it gave enough information that he's able to escape the gank as time logs move. Fortune's end again. Shadow needs another time log to make this work. He'll get it. He may die the tower, but Innocence, no, the heal is there. And Shadow barely survives. Also with a salve up his sleeve, can save Innocence the mana.
Oof, that was close. Nice faced edict coming out from Y. He definitely needed that tick of a heal to save him up there. And Wings, finally that observer ward is down inside of DC, so Faith can safely jungle.
So this early on, haven't seen the Invoker really being tested that heavily. Like, obviously, he still got that one death early on, but, like, Wings, how's your timing looking? Are you going to get your double blink daggers up when you're feeling comfortable?
The thing is, with the Invoker, they don't actually need too many items. They can easily set up with a Burrow Strike during nighttime. He has move speed built, too, with the Windlace or Chronosphere from the Faces Void, and just farm out with the Invoker. You typically don't see them getting involved too much. And it's not like you have a carry Naga on the opposite team, so they're okay. The main concern is the Mirana Axe.
Concern up on the top lane. Misery ready to wrap around the rear. He's got illusions available, so no problem diving the tower. But Faith, he understands something is wrong, but he can't see. Now you'll see the illusions arrive. But they just want this top tower. Support's on the way in the form of Innocence, heading to the top lane. T1 tower, there's no fortification, so Faith actually just running himself in. They've still got disruption as well as, and well, ensnares on cooldown for 2 more seconds. But TP, his face is void, Chrono is available. They're going to be careful in DC. The Chrono catching Sarsen's rules of Resolution. The Zone Strike will help them. They take one, they take two, they move to Resolution. Time lock him up. The Crush still on cooldown. Actually, no matter. Resolution will steal the damage. This stops the face's void from finding the kill. Resolution, he's walking out of here. And he gets away under the cover of the Moonlight Shadow.
At least Misery got the tower there, expertly baited by the Slaughter. He forced him to go on top of him and committed to that fight.
Mid lane.
Boy TP then.
Wee, Misery. Oh, okay. Again, the Forge Bros are blocking the angle. Sorry, Wee was sitting right on top of Blink. Like he was itching to go for the kill, but just didn't have the support for a bottom lane. They go for the kill. Sunstrike, Mu, gonna dodge it. Only barely, but turns on the 3 points up and scorched Earth. He's at life to survive. Ice dropping down. It was the Inferno Blade, which is still ticking him down to 38 HP. He'll make a break for the tree line and survive. As Mu, just reminding us all why the Doombringer is difficult to kill in that offlane position.
That was a really nice position by him, though. He expected a Sunstrike and actually ran towards the Radiant side, expecting it to go into his walking path. It actually shouldn't be. You shouldn't be able to dodge it at this point in the game if you place it just right on top of him. But, you know, it's normal to lead it a little bit. Link really needed that Sunstrike kill. His Midas is going to come out a little bit slowly. He's doing very well in terms of CS from Wii. The tables have turned since the last game.
They're going to try and create some space up on top. There's no level 6 for Ice. Faith does have the crush. They start with Barrow Strike Disruption. Soxa right on top of it. They still need to get that crush with a sprint forward. They can move over the Shadow Demon with no defensive disruption. It's an easy setup for the Sunstrike, but the damage still not there. The Barrow Strike! Ice gets three, catching Weeha mid lead. Tosca so low, but he doesn't die. Ice wants to be denied to the creeps. May not happen. Hiding inside the sandstorm, the arrow from Weeha pulls him out. But where is the mana? Ice doesn't have it. The last attack from Wee will do the job.
Wow, that's static, Link. He was just one hit away, but he had no damage. All of it was sucked away by that level 2 static Link, and they were just unable to chain their stuns, get a clean kill with the Sunstrike. That's what they're aiming for at this stage in the game. And falling a little bit behind in terms of XP as they search for kills around the map. And this is before Misery hits level 6.
Crazy thing to think when you don't have that Naga song to get you out safely. That level 6 you're talking about. But things can start to slow down a little too. DC holding the biggest gold advantage we've had the game so far, but it's not even 1,000. Shows you how close this is. Innocence currently being chased down by Misery. Faye's gonna rotate over. They start with a Fortune's End. This will hold him in position. Sunstrike, Crush, and there she goes. Very simple combo for Wings to execute.
Gotta respect the Sunstrike. And now Mu probably calling for someone over. He is level 6, ready to kill this Faceless Void. Looks like he will be going Lincoln's. See the start of the Perseverance. Perhaps Vanguard too, but I think with the Pulmy Shield, it's pretty clear that he's going for Lincoln's this game.
He can make Black weep by buying a Battle Fury on him. So that may make a lot of other people weep. There's that Hand of Midas timing, so 10-16 is how long it took for Blink to finish it. But this will now give him really good progression. He's already the top net worth on the field.
Yeah, pretty decently far ahead of the Murano. See a smoke gank Mu.
Yeah, they have Doom up and available. One thing they may reach is the Courier. That's too far away. Instead, they're rotating over. They're searching for Invoker. They don't have to really search that far. He's still attacking the creep wave.
That's a really hard gank to hit. Maybe if we had a better rune, but they're going to have to do it the hard way.
Blink is up far enough. You just scorched her, tank up the tower. You can start with Disruption and catch her. Blink may be far enough away with a Starfall. There's still four spirits available with the Disruption. Mu didn't find the target. The Barrow Strike from Ironside in the epicenter! He has to back up, he canceled it before he got doomed. And that is not the way to go. Resolution brings in the deeps, actually stealing the deeps away from the Slaughter. That Ice Epi was almost done. But Moose timing right in the money. The SD is down. Ice coming back in for more. Three stick charges. Not enough for that Barrow Strike just yet.
He's going to go in. Naga's not six.
Oh, there it is. They look for a Barrow Strike up. Goes towards Wii. He gets Infernal Blade. Ice actually getting nuked. Mu let out the Hadouken from inside of his chest. Invoker will get away. Resolution. Plaza Field in 3 seconds. Does he know? Does he know to go down? The Plaza Field. Here she comes. Too far away. The heal is there from Innocence. Wii will look for the arrow as well. Blink! He's stunned, but invisible. So he will be okay. But an interesting time for DC to start that fight up before Fortune's End is available, before that saving grace is up.
Yeah, they did not have the Faceless Void available for that fight. And that shockwave coming out from Doom really caught Wings off guard combined with the Starstorm.
So it brings the damage in. While Shadow not really involved, still got Chronosphere up. Ice. They have that one Observer Ward, which is now down freshly inside the Radiant Jungle, which scattered out the movement of the SK. But DC's backing up a very long way.
They need to get six on Naga first. They're taking it up on this troll camp really quickly. and now they can deal with a Chronosphere. Even, it's pretty good to interrupt the Sanking ultimate, too.
Weeha? Not certain exactly what his plan is here. Looking towards Faith, he hits the Starfall to begin, but no follow-up with Leap Arrow. Has to be careful going against the Slaughter, having leaped down.
Looks like Dire had to use Scan. I'm actually surprised they used Scan there. They have pretty good wards inside the Radiant side, and Faith's Void was already showing on the bottom lane, but perhaps looking to protect their precious Mirana while she still tries to farm up that Axe. Now that she's level 6, smoke coming out.
Here comes DC. Doom is off cooldown in 8 seconds time. Faceless Void already time walking back towards the tier 1 tower. No mistakes to be made here by Shadow.
He just has to make sure they don't like drop behind and place him as a reward. That's the easiest way to lose your T1 tower, is a smoke gank from behind.
Well, the Naga illusions can look for them. Don't need the Observer Ward when you got the illusions up. Shadow's out. Wings is heavily grouped up in the mid, both Ice as well as Innocence together.
They still need more time. Faceless Void's still really weak with just Perseverance in his inventory. Invoker hasn't had enough time for his Midas to kick in, and it looks like they will just sack that tower and look.
Well, they're looking for Invoker. Top lane, there goes your Disruption out. Catcher as well. Resolution starts up with the ultimate with Purge 2. Blink, he's just trying to kill off Soxa before he dies. The Sunstrike will be off target. And now it's DC's turn to have an easy execution. It will come as a trade-off. The T1 tower in middle lane taking considerable damage.
Smart movement from DC. Wings expect their whole entire team to be down there for that push.
Oh, they're coming in. Ice, he's got a haste rune. He looks to come from behind Fire Strike into the epicenter. The Chronosphere, it cancels the epicenter. It does catch out 2 DC players, however. But Ice now has to haste himself away. Fortune then out from Innocence, keeping that SK alive. He'll lose his own life in order to do such a thing. The Misery's right behind him too. Burrow Strike available, no TP scroll. So he goes down the hillside. Haste is off, arrow wrong way. You went west when the arrow went east.
And they will give up the chase. Yeah, not really coordinating too well in the Sand King. Ooh, we almost catching on Ice.
I think he's still looking for another one. There's, like, as far as vision goes, he doesn't have an Observer Ward watching the movement. Have to be one hell of a guess from Weeha to hit it.
Faith fairly close to his Blink Dagger, but not quite yet. Still sleep down for just a second.
Yeah, that'll give time for the crush. Innocence is on his way. Hasn't actually started up the Fortune's End. He's too far away from the Mirana for that.
And always has to be wary of that Sunstrike. But now we already see the early BOTs coming out from Razor. He is the most farmed hero in the game. Dragonlance, very good at spacing herself, so you don't have to get caught in the Chronosphere by the Faceless Void or get jumped on by the Sand King, who's still a long way away from the Blink Dagger. I like his item choice.
They all are. Iron Talons not paying off. This is how these guys break meta. Misery will have to fight, defend underneath the tier 1 tower. With Song of the Siren up, Wings have to be a little bit more cautious too.
The laning Iron Talon?
that's not a thing.
They expect you to go to the jungle though.
That they do. Maybe that's it. It's the next level mind game. Ice, sweet. He's getting really close to that Aghanim set, but then Wing's going to have a problem with the burst damage which DC can provide.
At the same time, though, they'll hit their timing with maybe the first item up on Invoker and the Lincoln Sphere on the Faceless Void. Right now, they don't have to worry too much about the Roshan. No signs of a Vlad. Mu, usually the builder of it, but this game opting for the Phase Drums instead. He has converted his Satyr to an Alpha Wolf aura, however.
Double smokes, DC, they smoked and went through the bottom river looking down to the bottom lane where Ice is currently farming up. But it's the double smoke coming out from Wings. They're going to see Weeha actually invis thanks to the Sentry Ward. Very quick Chronosphere, the nuke, the Sunstrike. Soxa, perfect place to cancel that one off, and the Song of the Siren. They may realize that Sentry Ward was down, hence they went on him. And the Song of the Siren will allow them to back out. So no Chrono, no Song, but they keep looking for the fight. Ice, the Invoker can die in the meantime. Shadow caught out by the Purge, as well as the Mirana a little bit further up. And with the ensnare, they'll hold Shadow in position. He time walks away a little bit of the damage. He's a little bit long with the Fire Strike. Epicenter from Ice in the back lines. He may find damage. He may have enough with the help of the Leap Away. The Mirana, she's not out yet. The Bash, it's the damage from Slaughter. He'll find it. Blinking over the crush. A double kill for Faith. You still have DC going in deep looking for the other kills, but Ice, the Burrow Strike up away from Resolutions only. Now the double crush. They don't want any more to do this, Wings. That Blink Dagger, Lone Pulp back on cooldown thanks to Plaster Field. They trigger the drum charge, but Wings back underneath their own tier 2 towers. Ice, what are you waiting for here? Razor's coming over. He'll hit him once. The Plaster Field will be enough to get the kill. Oh, why is he hanging around? The Pyro Strike was off cooldown as well, but he tried to save it. And Resolution gets a freebie.
Yeah, just more and more kills going the way of Razor. He is becoming incredibly difficult to deal with, all these melee heroes trying to go on him, but he just stands his ground, not really under any threat as Blink constantly gets picked off in the side lanes.
And he's going for a more of an early fighting build too. That Sun's just flying on the courier to him at the moment. So it's not an early BKB he's looking for. It looks to be an SMY to go along with that Dragon Lance. Plus the maneuverability, the speed he gets from the BTs. Like, he's already moving at 4-4-2. It's only going to get faster.
And that combined with the threat of the mana, it's going to be very difficult to Void to hit Kronos in these upcoming fights. And this is even before the Doom has come out onto him.
And Void's still trying to finish up. Like, he's not even thinking about a Blink Dagger at the moment. He's still trying to get that last bit of money in to finish up the Lincoln Sphere.
And I would like to see a four staff come out from one of Wings' heroes to deal with a static Link. They're getting a lot of damage from that.
They both need to get money. Oh, nice Sunstrike with the call. Snap, Misery gets hit. The crush on the Weeha. Fortune then holds him in position. The attack, he leaves and disjoints. Ice held back thanks to the purge from Zuxa, but it won't be enough to help him stay alive. Oracle purifying him with flames. And they'll take the tier 1 tower after the two kills.
And I like how they don't really... Like, normally when you're in this position of sinking, it's like, okay, I need a few more minutes for my Blink Dagger guy. Just let me stack up a camp or two. But no, they go the opposite route. They go for kills, they get the tower, they almost even get the Mirana with that. And not looking to lay off on the pressure here.
You don't farm creeps, you farm heroes. That's the way Wings want to approach this. They'll give him the top lane now.
They have to be careful to not get caught up by a Moonlight Shadow over here. They don't have any sentry wards in the area, and no one's showing on the map, so they won't actually know if they Moonlight Shadow up. They're in position to do so.
And with a TP arriving from Zuxa, comes in as that SD. Already Misery waiting in the trees, and that's that Moonlight Shadow you're talking about. Moo will walk forward. Ice is the one to go on, but where is your damage output? Fade's coming in. They just have to let him go down. He was so close to having his Blink Dagger, but it's stripped away by DC with a kill.
Yeah, 21.89, and that's what you get. You don't pay for sentries thinking that you can get away with it, but they were missing off the map for a very, very long time. That should always be a warning sign that Moonlight's about to come out.
Surprised he was still in underneath the tower so far. With the Observer Ward up from Wings, they do have good vision. They realize both Zuxa as well as Misery are on the back line. Space looking for the perfect Blink Chronosphere. It hits on the SD. The Crush, no Song of the Siren out. They already get the kill on the SD. Misery holding that ultimate while Resolution steals the damage. Faith away with a Fortune Dent. Resolution wants to keep fighting here. The Slaughter, there's a time lock. Song of the Siren, hold the fun, but wait for it. It will be released as the arrow flies in. Who's the connect on the Slaughter down instantly? Burrow Strike up into the epicenter. DC, the damage. They may have to bail out this moment. Ice, no Resolution. Kiting with the Plaza Field. Blink will finally arrive with the Deafening Blast pushing DC back. Call Snap Moo in a little bit too deep. Time Lock as well. They bring down Moo as he is forced back almost up to the tier 1 towers. A Sunstrike looking for a target. A little too early, however. Misery and Weeha were still trying to run away from the lane.
That was almost an excellent corner, but at least he caught the higher priority target. The Shadow Demon Socks has been on point with
the Shadow. Nice arrow, Weeha. You still have Blink here to deal with. The Four Spirits are up for Shadow. Time walks off the damage, just barely.
Oof. That HP from the Lincolns coming to help him out right there.
It's funny, they don't even trigger the Lincolns for him.
Still, the Razor is such a huge problem. Sinking, almost has his Blink Dagger, still 400 gold away as he perishes another time.
I'll let the guy have the mid lane, then he can catch up.
Yep.
Mid lane as well as the mid camps.
But they have Vlad's now on Doom, so now they can look towards Roshan Pit, maybe as the next Song of the Siren cools down, but he's only level 8 on the Naga Siren. They have to wait a whole 3 minutes in between songs.
Is this going to be like game number 1-2, where they play around Song, play around Faces Void Chrono? Obviously, that cooldown, as you said, like, there's a big, big difference between the two.
There's more teamfight ultimates this game, so they don't have to rely on just one big one for either team. The Moonlight Shadow can be used to initiate a fight like we saw on top. The Doom can go for solo picks with his very long cooldown ultimate. And on the other side, we have Wings with an Epicenter, which they can easily combo with Slardar to get some easy kills.
Wing is going to finally make use of this timing with a Blink Dagger on ISIS. They smoke up. They are headed towards the pit. The question is, they go? Nope, they arc up a little bit further north.
They were hoping that DC would take it without Song, because then that's perfect opportunity for jump them and get a really good lead on this game. But DC are not that careless. Rating has used scan. They expect the smoke. Not in the right direction, but they still kind of know what's up.
Well, they want to go in. Yep, they're going to slip inside the pit, but the TPs, they're arriving. DC. The scan was on bottom lane looking for the Naga Siren. Look how close they are. The plasma field from Resolution hits on Innocence, actually dropping him by half of his life. So they already start the heal. They get out of Roshan.
And with the Naga Siren illusions going to the pit and the song coming out cooldown soon, there's no way that they can do this Rosh. I don't even think if they like headed straight there and didn't go to the Ancients, I still don't think it would have been enough time. Not enough physical damage yet. Faced away with a defensive build and Invoker with just not many items at this point.
Now, this game is still so close throughout this entire, like, we've gone through 23 and a half minutes at the moment, and no one's held advantage over 1,000, really, in this entire game, both gold and net worth, just showing you how close these teams are.
It's all about the team fight. Can they combo Song with a Static Link before into, like, an arrow into a Doom, or is Wings going to get the jump on them with a finally blink on the Sand King into an Epicenter?
Yeah, that Epicenter always seems to come in just a little bit too late. You think it's going to have a big burst, but it doesn't. It is a level 2 Epi, so this is a difference which will be there for the Wings team fight.
It depends on how they start off the fight. Like, he has a couple of ways of doing it. One combo with a Chrono, but you expect the Naga Siren ult to come out if you don't get the Naga Siren. If the Naga Siren's in there, then yeah, you channel the Epi. But if it doesn't come out, maybe you wait until after the Chronosphere, wait until they're about to jump after the song, and then go in. So I don't know how ISIS is going to play. He's been in the fight a lot early, but that's because he doesn't have his Blink Dagger.
Well, with it now, he does blink straight over the top of the Dire Observer. What's her DC? Realize that Wings are doing an incursion towards the top lane.
Oh, there's the Ags on Invoker. I saw his item just a few minutes ago. It's like, he's on top of net worth, but he didn't look like he had that many items. But yeah, with a completed Ags, they have the damage.
He only bought it a minute ago, so.
Well,
bottom lane.
DC coming with a smoke on top.
Can they find their target? Wings are already bailing out. They bring both Innocence and Faith Beyond down the bottom lane, looking for Resolution. The Observer Ward is giving him the information they want. As Digital Chaos, they see ISIS onto their own Ops Ward. That's a long way to go. They don't have that easy jump in like you get from an SK. The SD and Naga have to close the distance the old-fashioned way.
Wonder what they're going to get on the Doombringer, because they ideally want him to initiate the fight. Like, starting with a song is very risky, because then you leave yourself exposed to the Chronosphere. And Razor, like, he's strong, but once he gets BKB, maybe he can run in. So Razor and or Doom is going to be your main initiators, unless you get a straight arrow. So a lot of different ways, but maybe going something on the Doom like Blink or Shadow Blade can open up a lot more options for Wings. Maybe not able to gank the Phase's Void, but everyone else can be an option. You want to be able to deal with the Invoker as he's split pushing.
There's the 4-star you're asking for. There's over on the Slaughter. So he's got both Blink and 4-star, a highly maneuverable team from Wings, while the Blink deck gets completed on Weeha. So that Blink into double Starfall and then leap away to safety will be problematic for Wings if they get hit by that before the fight begins. And Wings actually buying up a new item of their own. They instantly TP'd the mid lane. So once again, after the fresh Blink Dagger on Wings, this time it's on Shadow, they smoke up and they look for an opening on DC. The Observer Ward tells them everything they need to know. Burrow strike down. Soxa gets popped by the Invoker. Sunstrike, and then the Blink double cut. The Chrono, he'll catch out to Misery. The song comes out. The beautiful tones, at least beautiful for DC. The arrow will hit perfectly on Shadow, but ISIS, they're trying to keep up. Where's that 4-star forward? They don't have it. They look down into the tree line. They find Misery. Can't get out.
What a perfect time for a smoke. And I think if you trade Song for Chrono, it's actually pretty good for Wings, because now they can do Rosh without fear of reprisal from the DC side. You can't really go in there with Razor and a Doom. Maybe if Mirana hits an arrow, but that's a big maybe, and Roshan is dropping fast.
They let it go. Moose is up on top lane, farming up. We will push out the mid, so at least Wings, they can't just rotate down the bottom lane and take out the tier 2 tower. They must come back and defend their top and mid lane.
Oh god, look at Blink's items now. He is so farmed.
Regeneration. It was the Shadow Blade pickup from Rue. That was his item of choice.
Yeah, this is the best way to deal with Invoker. But now that he has an Aegis, it's like, you might have a lot of wasted time with your Shadow Blade. You can't gank the Faces Void with that.
Just kite him out, like let the Invoker sit in the back lines. while you kill off everybody else, if that's possible.
Yeah, I think that's how it's going to go. Ideally, you maybe even kill the Slaughterer at the start, but then again, you have the Oracle, able to just save anyone who gets doomed. It's difficult for them. I think Mirana has to be in there to do a lot of damage and pressure the Oracle to use his cooldowns very early on into the fight. A lot of this rests on Wii.
Well, this man is used to pressure. He's had a terrific tournament so far.
They need more tomes on the Naga Siren too. Like, she is really far behind in level. She's doing well on items, but you really need level 2 Song. Like, they're forced to play so defensively because of this, and the windows for Wings to engage just really huge. Now, Naga Siren ultimate is like way longer cooldown for Faceless Void. Faceless Void can find a fight perhaps in the next minute where DC can't respond.
Say hello to a fresh BKB over on Resolution. Avoid the Chrono, or maybe he can be a big influence in the fights.
He still has to be a little bit careful. Amplify damage with Force Spears beating on him and Sunstrike all can take him down during BKB.
I don't think careful is really in his vocabulary. He's running straight down into the lane. He'll actually Plaza Field, revealing the Slaughter. They're TPing out. The crush will happen. Slaughter has a TP scroll of his own. They have no stun on Resolution. But that was one man. DC were a mile behind him.
That's also a BKB reveal, however. Normally, you want to bait it out. It's like, okay, Sand King's going to go in with a Burrow Epicenter, then you turn around with the BKB. That's the ideal fight for them. But now that it's
Wings, face coming up. They don't realize that Shadow Blade's on the Doom, but now, okay, yeah, they do. They caught a glimpse of him as he backed up. Wings also scanned a little bit further up. They'll try to see if DC was going to move through the river entrance.
But they already have a gem on Slaughter. Yeah, I mean, they're not worried. Shadows
take us. At innocence cost, Moonlight Shadow forward. As he said, though, with that gem, this may be a big trap in the tree lines. Ice is close. Do they get a glimpse? The Slaughter's not far enough forward. Now they see Resolution. He reveals the fact that Moonlight Shadow was used.
The mid lane just makes this too obvious. Look at mid lane, look at top lane. The creeps are just beating on the tower. This is just a clear sign that DC are away and up to something funky.
So Wings, they remain patient. They don't find any pickoffs as DC bailed out, but DC were also very, very, very deep as far as Wings look into their jungle.
And Mirana's falling pretty far behind in net worth, at least relative to the Invoker. The Midas, the Aegis, all these have added up to him being a huge leader in terms of net worth. I'd be much more scared of a farmed Invoker than a farmed Razor, because Razor can only do so much. He also had to commit to a BKB, which isn't that much damage.
Now, how does Resolution, in fact, build from here? Do you try and go for this? Like, do you continue for a very heavy mid-game build?
I like the Shiva's build. Gives you a lot of armor versus Amplify, and you need that AoE presence in a team fight, so you can run in there. Your biggest fear as, like, a BKB hero is running there, and your whole team dies around you because you can't pressure them enough, you can't do enough damage, you can't soak up enough spells, and I think the Shiva's is kind of the perfect medium for that. You're also self-sufficient with the Static Link. You can link heroes without relying on a Disruption or a Demonic Purge or an Ensnare. And also just limits a lot of damage output, especially from summons like Invoker, Faces Void, who doesn't have that much attack speed. Although, as I say that, he has a Hyper Stone.
Well, you have the plate mail up, so it's fine. Where do they go? Down to bottom lane? Everyone's grouping up again, but in the trees, Ice stays there with an Observe Ward in the lane. He can make really good decisions.
Yeah, he can.
As far as not dying,
they can set up for an Epi Blink into Sunstrike, but it has to be on a weaker hero. Nagazaren actually has a gem. They will scout it out. They might kill him right now.
Oh, well, there goes your Obs. Ice.
I thought he was going to go on him right there. That would have been the perfect kill for them.
I don't see him in the trees.
Yeah, Ice no longer has any vision. He has to get out of there.
Blink's almost finished up his Lincoln Sphere. He's got almost all of it. Yeah. Sitting inside of his stash. Actually, no, he's finished it. It's sitting on the courier.
It's the best build to deal with the Doombringer. And Doombringer, you'll usually see them go for the Sage Creep, or sorry, the Purge Creep, to deal with the Lincoln Sphere, but at the same time,
be really careful. That gem is there from Faith. They understand the Doombringer's in the neighborhood. As the Observe Ward on the hillside gave Wings the good vision.
They're split pushing the sides, though, and Aegis will expire. DC have to be happy about that one. But they're still looking to pressure the side of the map. Will they be able to take down their Observer Ward before they have to defend the lanes? I don't know. This Observer Ward still sees them.
Yep, and here they come. Blink up, Slaughter, double crush, Amplify up with a double burst right from Ice, the Song of the Siren. It cancels the Epicenter. Move, Misery, Wee. It is Bale. The TP away to safety.
What a save coming out from Vim. Sinking. Yeah, the epicenter. He has to initiate. That's the problem right now. The Slaughter has to. He went in first, and they weren't really well coordinating that. They wanted to coordinate their stuns, but I have to applaud Misery with his positioning, too. As a Naga Siren, especially a support one, you never want to get caught out. And with all these blink initiations, the four stabs, and all these Yules and whatnot, it's extremely difficult to keep a low death count. This game, he's already had four, but not too troublesome. But now, they have Chronosphere. They want to take a fight with Chronosphere. There is no Song of the Siren. Shadow Demon now has to be the one to stay outside of the fight. Arrow almost connects to Shadow.
That Barrow Strike forward, ISIS, Weeha actually committing the double star fall to try and hit the SK. Not possible, and Wings just make the right decision. They're going for all the remaining outer towers. They take the mid, now they rotate top. They still have the advantage for another 115 seconds. That's until Song is back off cooldown.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
DC, they're trying not to get out farmed at this point, especially with the Invoker getting out of control, but Wings are only 2,000 gold ahead, although that will spike up after these towers, and with the next Roshan, has to be very troublesome. Naga's still not 11.
ISIS cops a 5-second arrow, but he's got almost every member of Wings around him. So there is no follow-up to this.
And as of right now, there's only one Observer War left on the map with the Battle of the Gems. DC only have eyes in the Radiant jungle as both teams circle around Roche.
Invisibility. Wings are assigned to stretch ahead. As far as the Golden Experience goes, we're either over or at 4,000 in both the Golden Experience. So Wings slowly, bit by bit, they're getting a small advantage in this game. Even if their team fight and the way the hero's been moving, it kind of feels like they got a huge advantage.
They have better split push threat. Despite the Razor having the early BOTs, the Invoker is just much better at pushing out the lanes because he can solo kill anyone who's out alone. Whereas the Razor, you can force them to run away, but you can't actually kill them. So DC are having their lanes shoved in at the moment. Not what you want as you eye the Roshan.
So does Wings keep farming up until they're at like an immortal position against DC? Or do they need to focus on finding kills outside the base? Because I'm thinking, like, how does Wings take the first lane of ranks? How do they work towards this objective?
It's a long process. Firstly, they have to push out the lanes so that DC split up. Ideally, you want to get the gem first. Once you limit the gem, then you can get Observer Wards, and then you can take Chronospheres when the Naga Siren's not there. You can get Epi Blinks when the Naga isn't there. You can get Slaughter to crush them with a Sunstrike when the Naga's not there. But it all depends on them having vision of DC, and DC, they do not want to split up as five and give Wings that opportunity. Once you do those, you can take down Roche and slowly make the siege. But you know, Dota's not a book. Dota's not a script. You can't just follow things like that. And you got to keep the Observer Wards up. So we see one Observer Ward up placed really
It's such a smart ward, too.
I barely see that one.
It's in the trees at the very eastern part of the Dire Jungle. And because Misery's sending illusions everywhere, because you have the gem on him, so they get true sight out from all the illusions, they've never found this Observer Ward. So Wings, they can see where DC are moving.
Yeah, those are the wards that win you games. Especially in the gem-on-gem war, it's extremely difficult to keep them up. And I think that's the one that's going to stay up for a very long time. Roshan looks like it's going to be a 2.5-minute respawn.
Well, the AC is done in time for it. So not too far up before DC can move down. So they have some nice auras to work with here, DC. At the same time, ISIS is trying to finish up his Aghanim Scepter. He's rapidly approaching it. This is his primary choice of item after getting the Blink and the Yule Scepter.
Dire, as you scan, ISIS looks like he may run into it. No!
Oh, he TPs. He's going top lane. He wants the money, remember? Like, if he's going to reach this Aghanim Scepter, he needs to get this top lane farm. Yeah, it's 100 gold away now.
The TP out super risky there. What if Roche were up or right after that Sunstrike? Then they could easily take it. If Wings try and go in there, then Naga Siren sleeps. I don't know if they know that ISIS TP'd up there, but it's very likely considering he doesn't have a TP in his inventory. Well, with this smoke up, it's going to expire. Maybe Wings can scout out with the help. Ooh. Well, they don't need four spears when you have a scan. It will land red.
Perfectly done.
Think they're in vision.
Well, that's the beauty of having the Observer Ward over on the edge of the Dire Jungle. They understand the DC are not in their jungle at the moment. And this allows Wings to use Shadow as bait. ISIS with a fresh axe, hoping to put it to use.
And a fresh Octarine on the Invoker. But that means very few buybacks on the side of Wings. They're throwing all their net worth on this impending Roche fight.
And DC are just hoping for an opening. But while this curve's on and while they group up, They didn't achieve anything. Wings was getting the farm they wanted.
Oh, Wings going to show in mid. He could get jumped out right here if they're not careful.
Well, they're headed down for Roshan instead. The Naga Illusions are on their way as smoke-covered Wings moving up to the Ancients. Weeha comes in the middle of a Burst Strike up. They find Resolution Crush as well. Can they kill up Weeha? No, the Leap Out. He'll get the start for Oracle. Purifies him with the flames once again. And it's Resolution bashed up. The fight splits into two different parts. Ice Isle down the back lines with the Chronosphere. Sunstrike's coming in. The damage isn't enough. Disruption. Zuxia tries to keep his core alive as Resolution runs away, but now with the time dilation, Tornado, it caught him! Thanks to the crush from Faith Beyond, Resolution won't die the fall, he'll die from the bash from Shatter, who finds a secondary one into Naga. Zuxia, he needs to get out, the damage is not enough! Sunstrike, no!
Oh.
He was drawn to the light, but you do not walk towards the light!
Oh, man. The crowd goes wild as Wings take down four. That was, man, I really like their positioning. They didn't go for the Mirana in mid, because that was the only hero showing you. Expect them to go up there. But they go in, they find the back line, and the sleep comes out, but Razor and the rest of his brethren fall. Mood, the sole survivor, as Wings close in on this T3.
And I can't wait for Weatherman Persia to tear that one apart. You thought DC had the high ground, but unlike Episode 3, it is Wings who take the advantage, and they will take the melee racks away from DC. Invoker, no disable, he'll get out safely.
The Slardar has been playing really well. This entire game, he's just been finding these multiple man crushes. That was despite like a really terrible laning phase by them.
Well, Sunstrike, it's all about Wings getting the damage in before DC can respond. They don't have Song of the Siren. Misery's moving over. That's on cooldown for another half a minute.
And
they
Chrono
actually find Mu into the epicenter.
No.
He'll die in the bottom lane. The mech is not enough. The arrow will connect on Shadow. Weeha, he jumps in. He needs double damage right now, but it's not there. Shadow time walks all off, and he's actually in the perfect position with the Burst Strike from my side. They catch out Weeha. Sentry is dying underneath the tower, so they can't keep the vision up. Moon Knight Shadow helping him to escape, but Zuxia will not be so lucky. The arrow will connect again. The DC, they lose three heroes trying to contest Wings on Roshan.
DC are imploding at this point, and Wings just played so carefully around that Roshan respawn. The way that the timing of their smoke, the items coming out at the perfect time in DC, they were just not prepared. They needed to be grouped up as five behind their cores, but they were just far too spread out, unexpecting Wings from to come around from behind.
Oh,
and
the blank Chrono! Oh. Resolution caught, amplifying to Sunstrike. They need more damage. The Burst Strike's gonna do it. Combining it with a crush. There's no Resolution. Mu will go down too. This will be it for DC. They've lost so much. They want to keep fighting. Misery, he'll go down as well. GG!
They thought they had the faceless void counter with the first pick Naga Siren, but this insane amount of stuns from coming out from Wings, their excellent team play, the farm on Blink. Oh my god, did it come together at the perfect moment.
Well, at least we get one of the dreams. There's a guaranteed four games here in the grand final. But Digital Chaos, there was a lot of smiles going into the end of the draft of game one. And now, well, the smiles might disappear, but they've still got to keep the mentality up. They've managed to bring the second game off Wings. Wings only losing one game prior to this grand final up against DC. It was a techies game. You didn't know if it was really going to be the thing, but we leveled the series at one apiece.
The meta has further developed. Faceless Void, not an auto loss versus Naga Siren, and Wii Mirana, not an auto win for DC. What's in store for the rest of this grand finals,
Kobe? I can't wait to see it, man. I know there's a couple of other guys that got opinions on what's next in store. Paul, are you with us?
Absolutely, yeah, we're here and enjoying a grand final. All we really wanted was five games, Ted. We're on the road.
Yep, I mean, this TI, I don't think it could finish any other way. That's 1-1, so we'll see how it goes. But it feels like the story has to end on a game five.
Yeah, absolutely. Cap, a great performance by Wings in that second game, really showing us the team playing. And Blink basically showing us that he can do whatever we can do.
Absolutely. I think Blink definitely stepped his game up. They had amazing team play on Wings. The combination of Faceless Void and the fact that they were able to make it work. Faith Beyond and Ice, oh my god. They just went so far out there when it came to the playmaking and being able to, like, there was one situation that, like, the top lane where I watched the initiation come out from one player, and I was like, uh-oh, that's going to be a Naga Siren Sleep.